My parents finally came to visit us here at Como Rebbe, so we spent the last 10 days hosting them, showing them our homestead and the nature that surrounds us. My mom and I got to visit and be with Fox, while Jake and my dad went out fishing together in the open Pacific Ocean.
Captain Rand.
Let's get it, Captain Rand. I just showed that movie to Nicole. We watched that last month, Captain Ron.
Oh, Captain Ron?
That's your brother.
My life as a new mom is getting better day by day, and I love raising my son and starting my new family with Jake. Should we have another baby?
It's a living sand dollar.
Here's a raw, unfiltered, and mostly unedited look at our life surviving off the grid in the middle of the Canadian wilderness, year 5. Please see our previous episode to see the new house we are building out of our own milled wood and recycled shipping containers.
Hey, 朋友,你做什么? What are you doing? Oh, no, don't sit on there. Oh, no. No, you're... Oh, no. No.
That's my start. Yeah, you want that one? Yeah, way better. Here. This one. Here. Right there, that one. No, get this one. I know there's a basket full.
It's like, I want what's in the basket.
Here.
Sorry for my legs here.
Well, they look sexy. Some sexy legs.
Scabbed up. Bruised up.
Can't see them from here.
Alright, so like a dozen cherry trees, the ones that we planted like 3-4 years ago, have cherries.
Oh, right there too.
Look underneath. Look, crouch down, crouch down. There's lots.
The worm on there. Is that your cherry from your cherry tree? Yeah, you want to take a bite? Here, I have to take the seed out. Yummy.
樱桃好吃，对吧？好吃。
You want another one? Can you give that to Dad? Hand it to Dad.
Chingewa.
Hand it to Dad.
My compost stained hands here.
He's like.
Aw, shishini. Shishini. Okay. Wagini. Thanks. This is my apple.
You have to share.
Mmm. Delicious.
This patch is cool because it's got our raspberries and then black cap raspberries we propagated, mm-hmm. and the cherry.
So good. You love raspberries.
He loves them.
You like? Can mommy have one? Aw, thank you for sharing. That's so good. Oh, you can have one now. Thank you. You're so sweet. Is that a tart one? You're gonna eat all of them. Can I have another one?
Okay, mama. Okay, mama.
Thank you. You want to give one to Dad?
Okay, watcher. Chingay watcher. Yeah, chingay watcher. Oh. Snub fest.
Can you give one to Daddy? One to Daddy. Here.
Shishi ni. Shishi.
Mama's gonna sneak one.
All right, take us your Hei Fu Penzi black raspberry. Hei Fu Penzi, this is very special. Jiga Tobia Houcher, Tobia Houcher. Oh my goodness. Try this. Babe. How's that taste to you? Like raspberry Gatorade.
Tastes very good.
It's a wild one. Yeah. Over here too. Let's go over this one.
He's holding his bowl like a Buddhist monk. Okay. There's your bowl.
He put his finger in a bowl, man. Okay, look. Ganbei. Boop. Okay, shenzai meiyo. Shenzai meiyo. Say zaijian. 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 Zaijian, zaijian. Shimma, shimma, here. Need the yingtao. Okay. They got. Okay, mama. Here we go. Okay, mama. Okay, mama. Okay, mama. Not.
Wow, thank you. I love it.
Okay, Mama Ying Tao. Okay, I'm gonna give me. Yes. I'm gonna eat it. Some mama bird action right there.
Fox, do you want to have the first strawberry? Are you excited? Look! Look what we grew you! You got it. Let me do this then. Oh, good job! There you go. Mmm, your garden strawberry. Cheers. Oh, it says he likes it very much. It's just a mouthful.
Mosquito bit you on the eyebrow, huh? Dinita Maymal. When's the ding?
I don't see any more yet, kid.
Nishihuan Taomei ma? Taomei?
Garlic scapes.
Ready? This hand. Oh, beautiful. Very nice. I like your jewelry.
Garlic scape bracelets, bro.
Wow. Yeah, let mommy have them. You want to put them on mommy? Awesome. There we go. So styling. Your turn. Here you go. More? What more? Look at the scapes. Oh, they're still attached. There we go. Like, you want to smell? Good job. They smell good? Hey. So we can dry them out. Here, come here. Here's our dehydrating rack that you guys seen us build a couple years ago. Are you gonna show them what we have dehydrating, Fox? Yeah, so here's the oregano that we just harvested and put on trays down here. And then we have a bunch of trays of our garlic scapes that we're going to dehydrate and then blend up and make into garlic powder. Some chamomile flowers. I just have a couple right now, but there's going to be a bunch coming here very soon. So there you go. And Fox making a mess. Thank you.
Cherry, apple, and plum.
Wakes up from his nap and the first thing he wants is some huckleberries. Here's some more. This kid loves berries. All of them. Yeah, look, I have some in my hand. Once you eat these, I'll get you more. Here you go. Yeah, huckleberry. Oh no, you dropped both of them. Here, take this one. Yeah. trailer ride. There's our new house.
All right, let's
go. Let's go, Dad. Look at your hair. It's crazy. Here we go. Get some done on your face. Whoa.
Here we go.
That was it?
That's it.
Orchard. Yeah. So what trees did you just plant?
These are the five border trees that are like 80 foot wide canopies, walnuts and chestnuts that in 10 years will be huge, and they're like the perimeter of the property, and then they're also on the outside, so they won't shade anything that's on the inside. So then all the fruit trees
will be all over there.
Cherry will be inside. These guys can be the big ones in the back, and those ones can be the pruned ones in the front.
Perfect.
What's up? Did you just have a shower and now you're getting all dirty again? Mom just showered you off, bruh. Ah. Ready, and shoo. Tell me that the baby alder in the foreground doesn't look like bamboo. I always say the alder is the bamboo of the Canadian wilderness, and look at it, it looks like bamboo. He's been waiting a year. Remember when he's a little baby? Back to the Future, back in time when he first tried tomatoes, he loved them so much. Here, a few more. Hey, Jacob, okay, mama. Okay, mama. Hey, mama. The first ones. Hey, give me.
Yummy. Some garden fresh tomatoes. Oh, let's go get the berries. They're up here.
Babe, we have so many black caps now on the property at Como Rebbe, but this is... Babe, we have so many black caps at Como Rebbe now, but this is still the mother plant, yeah?
Yeah.
All of our cuttings came from here. He's been picking so many raspberries, he wants to pick the red ones, but he needs to learn those are black. Where are you going?
Bye.
No, come here, this one.
There's not a whole lot red on this one. Be careful. Ooh, did it get ya? Yeah, it's spiky. Here, look, mama. Yeah. There you go. This one right here is ready. Where are you going?
Come here, come over here.
Right here. See mama's finger? Here.
In the back.
Look right here. Can you pick this one? There you go, gently. Yeah. Those ones aren't ready yet. Goodbye.
Go for it. Can I get the ones in the back of sandals?
Yeah, good luck with the shorts on.
See, Fox and I were here off camera last night and we picked like 100 of all the ripe ones.
But when they're darker like that, you want them. Here you go.
Here you go.
Mimi. Here. This one. This is the one right here.
I'm stuck. Ah. It's like a bunch of kitten's claws all at the same time. Oh, my toe is stuck. Ah.
Okay, bye.
Yeah. Oh, I see. Yeah, we see some thimbleberries. See, thimbles don't have any thorns. Here you go. Oh, look at this one. Really good one.
Yeah.
Hey, mama.
Nice.
Which one do we have here? What do you see here? What is it? You? Nikon Yuma? Yeah, it's inside there. Okay, here, you hold this. We'll see which one we have. You ready? You see him? Last night's salmon?
Looks awesome. What are you gonna do with it?
I think I don't want to just eat it. I like to smoke it, but it's not enough to fill the whole smoker. So maybe we should all fillet it and then freeze it. And then I'll focus this week on catching like 3 more. And then once we have them all together, then we'll smoke them all. What do you think?
Perfect.
Or do you want to just eat it fresh?
I think you freeze it and then go out and get some more.
We have a...
We have enough cod in there, so we can eat cod and then smoke this.
Yeah.
Just your nida yu.
Here, you tell me which one it is. That one? You think it's a chum? I don't think so. Which other one do you think?
I think we have coho. Yep, I think that's the one it is, coho.
Nicole catching a workout and just want to show you guys one salmon. Just one fish. Super blessed. Amazing. As Nicole and I try to forage, grow, harvest, and catch our way off the food grid, we are using a variety of methods to provide all our own food. Canning, jarring, drying, pickling, freeze-drying, and solar-powered freezers are how we are preserving our food currently. The ocean is so abundant, and even though catching a salmon or a ling cod or a halibut with a pole is a good way, I've found that the best and most dependable way to bring fish home for my family is free diving and spearfishing. I use a rubber band powered gun and a pole spear sling. For me, this is a more athletic way to catch food than just using a pole or a downrigger and hanging out on the boat waiting for a fish to bite. I'm working on body and breath athleticism and control while seeing the underwater world that is ever changing season by season and so beautiful. I get to see the fish in their natural habitat and I get to see their natural behavior. On this day, I was hunting a few nice-sized rockfish when I was surprised by a beautiful ling cod just sitting on a rock right next to me about 65 or 70 feet down.
Do you see Dada out there? Where is he? Is that a fishy? Good job. Fishy face? Okay, what fish did you get?
There's a lot of fish down there.
Yeah?
And it's just beautiful down there. But it's harder to see because it's summertime, so there's a lot more seaweed, so it's the visibility is less. I don't know how much the camera picked up, but I was just like, I'm looking for a ling cod and I'll get some rockfish. I got some good sized rockfish, and then there's some amazing black rockfish, so I'm like, okay, I gotta go back. I'm sure Nicole wants to go. Right? There's some really nice black rockfish, and I go down there for a deep dive. And I was gonna go real deep, like 80 feet, to try to film. There's amazing anemones at the bottom in the sand.
I was like, maybe I'll see something in the sand, like a halibut. I'm always thinking halibut. So on my way down, I had the camera going and I saw a big black rockfish, and I'm like, that's the biggest one of the day. And then I just looked, and like next to me was a cliff and this lingcod is just sitting on, just like we're looking at each other face to face. So I just, and I happened to have the power at 3/4 power on this spear gun, so it was pretty good power. I just kind of slowly stayed calm, I kind of reared back, no big movements, and I just shot him right in.
Nice.
So I got the lingcod. Fillet one for you. It's like for a family of three, it's like two or three meals, just one fish, yes?
Yeah.
Save all the rest of this head and skeleton for crab bait, yeah?
Yeah. Can you put soil in this cup for me? Yeah. So we can plant our onions that we grew ourselves? Yeah. Fill these cups up. Here's our onions that we're taking from our big onion plant. You have more onions there? Oh, you do. Thank you. We have to plant those ones too.
You want some lettuce tonight?
Yes, please.
Here's one. Kind of this pop up in the middle of the potatoes and zucchini here. So. It's two. Beautiful. Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
No.
How about the first? Blueberries. Not ready. Lawn May. There you go. Okay. Check out Lawn May. Gay mama. Gay mama. Ah. Psych. Mom gets one. Can I get half? Fox gets one. Everyone's happy. Hey, Shenzai Mayo. Mayo. No, those aren't ready yet. Let's see. What are we gonna do, I think?
We're gonna jack it up.
Jack it up.
Jack the shipping container up.
See that corner there?
This one?
Yeah, do you see how the corner is sticking up? That could be the highest point.
Yeah. So what's the verdict?
I think this container, like at first glance, it appears very nice, like it's sitting flush on the blocks, on all the corners, right? But it's, if you level the whole structure as one unit, this one's lower. Jack up this container, where these are on the same level, and then I've milled with the chainsaw mill a bunch of like live edge shims that I've hit with the flame to char them so they're weatherproof, and then put a big shim underneath there. So let's see if I can even do it.
He's just messing it up. Hey, Dad just put those there, bro.
What's crazy about lifting this one here?
You're lifting another one on top.
Lifting two containers with this little tiny bottle jack. So I feel like this shim is too much. I'm just gonna like do a proof of concept, right? So like that one underneath there. I just need two more inches. Is he gonna remember any of this, or is it just gonna be like inherently part of his character? Okay, bye-bye. Okay, let's see. I got it jacked up. Let's see. More inches. Shims are like that size. Like, if you look across the three containers, is that way better now?
Yeah, it does.
And we'll slap a level on there, and then as I jack it, we'll see where the bubble goes. Right? Ah. Let's see on the inside if the floor was like this before. Let's see if it's more level. Woman, yeah. Yeah. Okay, chip. I'm gonna get you. Oh, I was gonna get you. Let's go. Yeah, is this less of a gap, do you think? Like visually, what do you think?
Let me get in and look.
It's the third container we jacked up, right? No, it's not. It's this one we jacked.
That's the last of the gaps. There's no other gaps anywhere else.
You think? Okay. Containers already had insulation spray underneath them before they came here. It's the same thing, like an inch and a quarter.
Some more oregano in there. Here we go, I'll just add. Just ready, mix it around. Good job. Here. What do you see? Blueberries? You have some black cap raspberries on your lip. Can you say good morning to the people? Good morning, people. We're just out here picking some blueberries. I'll give you a better look. We're gonna pick some blueberries, have a little snack. We're gonna walk to the lake this morning, a little morning hike to the lake. Is that yummy? See yourself? Oh, I think we're just gonna pick all these blueberries as they come in and not save any for jam. Because we keep coming out here and eating all of them as they ripen. Mmm! So yummy. So yummy. Can I have one? You can have this one right here. This one's more blue. Yeah, that's all of them. I don't see any more that are ready. Nothing like fresh picked blueberry from the garden to start the day to go on a hike. So the lake. Oh, I see one more. Okay, we gotta give this one daddy. This one's perfect. Look at that one. That one's really nice. Okay, we're gonna give this one to dad because we had a lot. Should we share? Yeah, we're gonna put this one away. Okay, let's go to the lake. What's that? Can you give that to dad?
This is your long name. Okay, well, oh. Ready? We'll share.
Do you hear ginseng? There's some more. Huckleberries and blueberries to start our journey on our hike. Oh, you can see me in your glasses. Hi.
Huckle. You want some off the tree? How spoiled that he won't take them from my hand. He wants them directly from the tree.
I know. He wants to pick them himself.
Okay, here we go. Look.
Hi, ginseng.
Oh. Ginseng's biggest fear is not cougar, it's 1.5-year-old baby.
Yeah.
Don't hold that for me.
Here's how we here's how we keep the bears away, okay? Ready? I like this. Oh. You just hit when the camera comes on, bro. Here you go. Get us there. Watch, here we go together. Row. Row. Should I dive? Look. Shoo. Dive. Okay. Whoa. Yeah. Watch. Shenzai wo yo yong. Ready? Yo yong. Yo yong. Yo yong. Yo yong. Yo yong. I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna get you.
Oh yeah, sure.
What's that? Is that a starfish? You don't want to hold the starfish? No, you can just look at it then.
No. Yeah, so Nicole and I, you know, any of the vertebra or the heads of the fish that we catch, we just use as crab bait or prawn bait, and a bunch of crab have had their way with that, and then we get to have crab, male Dungeness crab, that are of correct size. That's the bait. So that was lingcod bait, so now we'll try the fresh salmon and see if they like the salmon here. Size of the lingcod head there. So salmon and lingcod combination.
No, you don't like it? Thank
you. Just hook it on there and then it goes inside the crab trap.
You
want to
throw the sucker back? You want to throw it back in there for me? There you go. Say bye-bye, starfish.
Bye-bye,
starfish. Bye-bye. See ya.
Hey, say bye-bye.
Zaijian. Bye-bye. He said, yay, back at my home. Bye-bye.
Hey, so what's our depth?
We're at 188.
Perfect. Right here, nidio, go. Ready, eat, arasan, wah!
Yay! So it's the next day.
Hey, and this trap's got three.
All right.
Good size ones too, big guys. How many harvests think this bait will get them?
I don't know, maybe one other time.
Maybe one or two. What do you think?
Nice.
Thank you.
What about go, 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 go. Nice squats. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Wanna see something? Come on, I'll show you. Ready? Keep going. Whoa, 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 whoa. Stay there. Ready? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Here we go. Ready? Watch. Here we go. Check it out. Wow, wow, yeah. Turn, let's see you do it. Wow, ready? Again, here we go. And, wow, wow, shoo. Whoa, whoa. And down, and up. The beginning of a chain of